Over 1.16 billion pesos already awarded to those affected by the Duterte administration siege against militants in Marawi. The Marawi Compensation Board told senators an additional 36 billion pesos is needed to cover all the filed claims on deaths and damages to properties and infrastructure. The siege of Marawi was a five-month armed conflict in 2017, waged between state forces and Islamic State militants.
Mula noong July 3, 2023 hanggang July 4, 2024, kami po ay naka-receive ng 14,495, almost 15,000 po na nasiraan, nawalan ng hanap buhay at namatayan. Sa madaling sabi, hanggang June 10, 2028 na lang po ang lifespan ng aming ahensya kasi nasa batas po, 5 taon lang po.
The Philippines' housing chief warns the country could become the world's biggest slum area if the government does not address its housing backlog. Housing Secretary Jerry Acuzar made this remark to senators while pitching his agency's proposed 2025 budget. Acuzar admits the Human Settlements Department slashed its construction target to just 3.2 million homes since construction takes at least 2 years. The Philippine government estimates over 500,000 informal settler families are occupying nearly 3,500 hectares nationwide.
Bakit po nagbago po yung 6 million to 3.2 million? Kasi po, nung mag-meeting po ulit kami doon sa cabinet, sinabi po ni Secretary Balesa, baka medyo mataas yung 6 million. Baka yung needs ay 3.2 million muna. So, doon muna kami.
An official of the Human Rights Commission reveals possible causes of delay in the construction of a museum honoring martial law victims. Let's get more details from our correspondent Vivian Gulia. Viv.
Hi, Rica. Delays in the construction of a memorial museum honoring martial law victims may be attributed to the seeming foot dragging of the University of the Philippines, according to an official of the Human Rights Violations Victims Memorial Commission. The project named Freedom Memorial Museum is planned to be built on a lot inside the UP Diliman campus, covered by a usufruct agreement. During the budget briefing of the Commission on Human Rights before the House Committee on Appropriations on Tuesday, HRVVMC Executive Director Carmelo Victor Crisanto told lawmakers that the commission finished its part of the agreement with UP in October 2022, but UP has yet to sign the turnover document. He issued a statement in response to the question of Gabriela Partilis representative Arlene Brofas. The HRVVMC sought Congress's help in nudging UP to fulfill its end of the obligation. It plans to reach out to UP again to resolve the matter. Crisanto last met with UP officials in April. CHR's budget sponsor, Negros Oriental First District Representative Jocelyn Lim Tai Chong, said the panel will write to the UP administration to explain the delays. She said that the old building and the site for the museum will have to be vacated first. House Committee on Higher and Technical Education Chairperson and Baguio City Representative Mark Go also gave assurances that he will call the UP president and bring the matter to the next UP Board of Regents meeting. Republic Act 10368 created the HRVVMC primarily for the establishment, restoration, preservation, and conservation of the memorial, museum, library, and or compendium in honor of the victims of human rights violations during the regime of late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr., the father of incumbent president Ferdinand Marcos Jr. That's the latest from here. Back to you, Rica.
Thank you, Vivian Gulia, reporting live.
The Philippine government's media regulator admits it is unable to police content in online streaming platforms. MTRCB officials told senators at their Tuesday deliberations it is also powerless to act on complaints about adult content provider Vivamax. The agency's chairperson, Lala Soto Antonio, cited limited manpower and lack of jurisdiction to monitor online media content. Instead, she proposes government cooperation with online streaming platforms to come up with the necessary safeguards.
We want to ensure that there would be a cooperation with the online streaming apps, with the online curated content providers, by using safeguards, ensuring that there is safety by design. When we establish a strong feedback mechanism with a focal contact point from the OCCs, then it is going to be easy for us to address the concerns and complaints from the general public, especially the parents, who continue to be very bothered about what the content that their children are exposed to.